This is Simba, you can hear, stealing the show. What Hello. Do we... We do Good what boy. We can to care Good for our boy. Pets, but we often forget about their dental Good health. Boy. With an estimated 80% of dogs with dental disease by 3 years old, we've invited vet Paul Hansen to the show to show us how to protect our pets from disease with some simple dog brushing techniques. Welcome to the show. We've got Ita's dog Cleo and also Simba, who's feeling very frisky this morning. How important is it to look after your pet's dental health?
Sarah, it's really important. Gums are like the gateway into the body, so any inflammation or infection or dental problems that our pets have allow bacteria into the bloodstream, and that then can result in a lot of other issues.
So what are the most common problems, Paul?
Most common problem tends to be calculus, the thick, hard plaque that builds up on teeth, and that then lifts the gums over time and causes inflammation and infection, and you can wind up losing teeth. Problem with our pets is because they can't tell us if they're uncomfortable, we have to look for changes like different eating habits or that kind of thing to kind of indicate that there's a problem, plus bad breath. That's the right. classic that we all know.
Doggy breath.
It's all right.
Now, you're going to show us the best techniques for brushing our pet's teeth. And before you do, Jessica had a bit of an attempt to brush her cat's teeth. We must have a look at this.
I couldn't get them. That's Alfie. He would not open his mouth.
It's a noble effort, Jess.
Same vein as herding cats. How is her technique?
Well... Look, it's a noble aim. The problem is it's a compliance issue. You've got to have someone who can do it every day and a pet that's willing to have their mouth open. And cats are...
There's Daisy. She wouldn't open her mouth either.
Cats, as we know, aren't willing participants a lot of the time. That's the difficulty.
And you just use your standard Oral-B toothbrush.
Well, that's the other problem.
Colgate?
I've brought along today some of these little softer finger
there
brushes. These are really good, and you can get them from your local vet and pet stores. So they're like a little silicon thimble.
Oh, I just saw the other end. They look like something else for a second.
So how do they work, Cleo? Sit.
So
that reminds me, I've got to get my prostate checked.
Not today, Joe. The principle with this is they're more likely to accept your finger going into their mouth than they are a foreign object kind of thing. So, you know, as we can see with Cleo...
Oh, she's such a good dog. She flossed this morning.
You can just gently rub like that. And because it's your finger, she knows it's me, or she would know it was Ita, and she'd be a lot more tolerant of it. But you've got to do it every day. That's the thing. And the other thing you need to do is just make sure you have a check with your vet first so that... You know, you're not causing any more problems and you've got the proper kind of oral hygiene maintenance regime. Check up first. Sometimes you need a clean and polish to start off, but then once you're a blank slate and ready to go, daily action like this. And
toothpaste?
There are pastes that you can use, funny flavours, chicken, biscuit, cheese, beef, something
yummy.
For everyone.
The from the gums down, like they tell humans?
Yeah, just the gums? Along the arcades, at the level of the gum tends to be best. And then she'll go and have a drink, rinse her mouth, because she won't sort of rinse
Gargle.
And spit. Yeah, we rely on her having a drink. But it's got to be every day.
Paul, thank you so much for coming in and showing us how to do that. It's wonderful. Thank you for that, mate. We'll hang on to those for you, Joe.